spending 3 nights solo camping. I'm traveling a distance of about 16 to 18 kilometers a day. 3 campsites, lots of portages. I need this. I need the solitude, I need the challenge. Come along with me, I think you're gonna enjoy this one. I'm ready for the adventure.
Good morning. Well, that was a fantastic sleep. A solid 9 hours. Time to get up, eat some breakfast, and paddle on. I've never slept so good at this trip. I've never slept so good as this trip. That's hard to say first thing in the morning. Only got one black fly bite that's pussing, and it's on my arm. Not too bad.
What I do before I get out of bed, because I have to empty my sleeping pad air, is just empty it while I'm laying on it. That way my body pushes it all out, all the air out, and I'm not stuck later on trying to force the air out, squeezing it, rolling it down. I can feel it all empty. And you can really feel how much the sleeping pad makes a difference when you're laying on it. And it deflates, and then you can feel the ground underneath. Sleeping pad for the win. Gotta get up. 6:30. Time to get up and get out of here. Got a big day.
Big day.
Gotta get up. Big day.
I'm sure glad I went without the tent flay last night. I got a ton of condensation in there still. Got that stuff hanging up to dry.
Some of the sounds I heard last night were unbelievable. Sounded like a trumpeter swan to me, but I don't know that they have them here. Sounded like a trumpet either way. Maybe that's why I'm thinking that. That mixed with the bullfrog chorus. Man, wild last night. I am super glad that I decided to stay at this site. I would have never chose this site just for the location, the Grassy Bay, but I'm completely secluded. Got the dragonflies, the bullfrog chorus, the tadpoles, the no bugs, the big open campsite, wood. I'm blessed, man. Super happy, super lucky to be here. Just gotta make a quick breakfast and I gotta get out of here because I gotta put about 8.5 hours under my feet today. I'm glad, again, that I stopped here yesterday early. I kind of gave myself a little rest day, even though I paddled half the day. It was an easier day. I don't really want to mess around today with making shavings or trying to find birch bark or anything like that. So these are some cotton rounds, not cotton swabs. Sorry, cotton rounds, not cotton balls. My wife uses for makeup. So I got those with the petroleum jelly on them, obviously. Rip it up a little bit. I'm gonna hit it with a fire steel. And that'll go up quick. I can throw my twigs that I put here last night right in. And then we'll be good to go. Just add some fuel. There we go.
Goodbye, sight. You're a good one. Feeling good today. Nice and rested.
feeling rested, I'm feeling energetic, full of piss and vinegar. Ooh, a lovely spider in my boat. There you go, fishies. What a beautiful day. On the water by 7:30. Not too bad. An hour to get up, break down camp, eat breakfast, get in the water. There's a beaver swimming far in front of me. Can't see it on the GoPro, I'm sure.
Look at that flower. I've been seeing it all through this marsh. Almost looks like an orchid style. Probably can't even see me, that backlighting so much. It's 8:30. I've been paddling for an hour. This grassy bay is very hard to navigate. So there's branches that go off in different directions. I finally found the way that I need to be going. It wasn't that bad. But like I said, I'm still paddling in this grassy bay and it's been an hour. It's 8:30 in the morning and the sun is brutally hot. I have my collar flipped up. Ever since I can remember, I've been my collar. Anyways, I got my collar flipped up. Just trying to protect myself from the sun. I gotta stop at the first portage, lather up on the old sunscreen. I have a 725 and like a 510 back-to-back portage. So I'll be happy to go to the boat. But once those portages are done, I'm sure I'll be happy to get back in the boat. Hey, listen, guys, I'm kind of nervous about not finding my portage. It's supposed to be right at the end of this thing, and all I can see is marsh and trees. Usually you can see the portage sign, and in this bay, they've put up big signage in the water saying which access is where, because it's so unnavigable, or hard to navigate, I guess. But I see no signage, I see no portage sign, and I should be right up on it. So unless it's past this little patch of alders right in front of me, I'm gonna have to backtrack and search to my right, which I don't wanna do, man. I really don't wanna turn around. Wish me luck. Water's getting quite low.
Oh, this is gonna be a lot of it. There's another one. Son of a gun. I guarantee this is the wrong way.
I'm gonna turn around. I went up to that the second beaver dam right there. Got out, and there was a boot print in the mud. One boot print. Which leads me to believe that somebody did the same thing as me. Got there, got out of their canoe to either bring it over or to look, because you can get a higher vantage point. I got out there, I walked around, I didn't see any more boot prints, and I didn't see any portage signs. So I'm gonna turn around. There's a little stream that went to the right. I'm gonna try that. This whole trip has gone off without a hitch. There has to be something. Wouldn't be an adventure if you didn't get turned around once or twice.
Going the wrong way wasn't all bad. I'm going back and now there's a big moose right in front of me. He's just staring at me. He's eating. Can't be too scared if he's still eating. Oh look, he's coming towards me. That's good.
That's what you want to see. It's a big animal, man. He does not care about me at all. I'm about 30 feet out now. I circled around him. I've been talking to him, letting him know I'm here. He doesn't really care too much, which is pretty cool. I have not spent this much time around a wild animal this size. It's a young bull. He's see his antlers coming in. All right, I gotta get going. I gotta get going, buddy. See you later, Bullwinkle. Well, that was about as epic as epic can be. The only thing better would be finding this darn portage now. I spent a good half an hour hanging out with that guy. I have no idea where this portage is. Sucks. I gotta pee again. Okay, well, I've come into a school group here after my inadequacies of finding the portage. It's 11:30, so I've spent all morning trying to find it, can't find it. These guys are going the same way, so I really hope they're better at canoeing and navigating than I am. So maybe we'll be able to find the portage and not have to backtrack. There's moose number 10. That's the sixth moose I've seen today. And he's right in my way this time, and he's big. I guess I'll hang out here for a second. Since I last seen you guys, I met up with that school group. There's two leaders and a bunch of high school kids. And it took myself and the two leaders 2 hours to find the portage. We found one, and it wasn't one, it petered out. We were walking and it was just rough going. Went back bunch of times, finally found it. So it has taken me 6 hours to do what should have taken me 2 hours, and my day should have been an 8-hour day today. So to get to my destination, I have some distance to move. And there's this big old bull moose. Where is he? Right there in my way. Yeah. So this is a dose of reality. I was having too easy of a trip. And yeah, I don't think I can make it to Bandit Lake today. If I do, it'll be like 9 or 10 o'clock by the time I get there. I'm wiped out already. It's 1:30. I've gone nowhere. Moose number 10. Wow. Well, we're just gonna make a lot of noise and we're going to paddle right on past them because it's not rutting season. Although he is a bull moose, I hope he doesn't take offense or an aggressive stance towards me. Hey buddy, I'm just paddling on through. No need for troubles. You're a good boy. I like your velvety antlers and your ball chin. I'm just gonna keep on talking to you as I paddle on past you. Because I don't want no problems. You're a good boy. Well, that was relatively close, within 20 feet. And he does not care one bit. So thank God for that. We need to make some distance. That group behind me is a lot slower, but they're coming up to it too, so I hope they do all right with it. I'm at the end of the McIntosh Creek portage. I have to paddle across McIntosh Lake, 4:05 into Timberwolf, 8:45 into Misty, 10:30 into Muslim, 3:70 into Winona, and then 5:40 into Bandit. That's a full day still. It's 2 o'clock. How is that gonna happen? I might have to camp on Winona, but in all honesty, it's only a 540 meter portage away from Bandit. So I think what I'm going to do, just finish my little sandwich here, doing water. I'm going to header, man. I'm just going to balls to the wall today. Just drink a ton of water and just paddle my little butt off. And I'm gonna get to Bandit Lake. There we go. I've said it. I've made up my mind. I'm going to get to Bandit Lake tonight. Oh yeah, one more thing. I've traded black flies for mosquitoes.
I think everything's going to be okay. I think I'll get to the camp on Bandit Lake around 6 or 7. It's 3 o'clock now. I've done, in an hour and a half, I've paddled through Timberwolf. I've paddled through, the heck was the other one, McIntosh. And I've done 3 portages, 7 and 2 fives, all in an hour and a half. I have not been dicking around and busting my butt, drinking water on the go, eating food on the go, and it's made a big difference. So I think everything will be okay. Woo! Feel the burn. Oh man, I'm happily single carrying every portage. Still happy about it.
I just did this big 10:30, kicked my butt. Now I'm into Muslim Lake, and all I have to do is scoot across Muslim, which is a small lake, 370 meter portage, scoot across Winona, which is a small lake, 540 meter portage, and I'm into Bandit. And there's a campsite right at the end of the portage, and one on the island as well.
Good times. Approaching my last portage of the day from Winona into Bandit, and it's all uphill. It's a 540, not too bad. The portages have seemed that they're getting longer. It's not that, I'm still cruising through them. I'm just getting tired, real tired. Last portage for the day done. This looks to be like the island site to me. There's no sign on the tree, but that doesn't mean it's not. It could be around on the other side. It could just be gone. Get in, check it out. The other one was facing a better direction for sunlight and sunset. So if this one, unless this one's really good, I am gonna go back to the other one, I think.
Nice and open. I don't feel too many bugs either. Oh, here we go. Oh, firewood. That's a helpful. Yeah, you know what? That's a pretty good view, I'd say. Ow, tripped a log over a log. There's the other campsite. Right through there. You know what, I think I'm calling it. I'm gonna stay here. There's barely any mosquitoes, which is a huge plus. And the firewood, it's a good site. So this is it, this is home. Now time to do water, food, tent, breathe. It's 5:03. So I made some time, man. I'm gonna do the calculations later on, but rough day. food. Always at the bottom. I ate all my snacks, all my trail snacks today. All the easy stuff on the top of my pack. I need waters. All the waters. How do I look? How am I looking? Pretty good or what? Yeah. Remember when I said there was no bugs? Well, that was a gross misunderstatement. Misunderstatement, is that a word? Misunderstatement? Gross understatement, that's the term. Misunderstatement. I think I'm losing it, guys. I dumped my food out to kind of assess what I have, what I can eat, and what I need to save for tomorrow. Tomorrow I should only have like a 4-hour paddle and portage, but anyways, travel for 4 hours tomorrow before I get to the car. So I know that I'm gonna want, well, this is my breakfast, this is my oatmeal, that's done. My supper is for tonight, that's done. But tomorrow, I've got two and a half of these pepperoni, I can't remember what the heck they're called, they starts with an L, Lajin something. Anyways, dried pepperoni, really good. So I figure I have one Baby Bell and one of those for tomorrow would be good. Also, a new Nature Valley would be good. A fruit thing would be good. And a chewy granola bar would be good. So I have this for tomorrow for 4 hours, which should hold me over. You know what? Let's live a little. We'll bring the raisins as well. So that's gonna go in this bag here. So I know that I can't eat that. Oh, what else do I have? What else do I have? Oh, bear bag and toothpaste. That doesn't help at all. So tonight, oh, this is for tomorrow too. Tonight I can eat those pepperonis, those chips, those M&Ms, that bar, and one thing of raisins. Oh, and I have my Frank's Red Hot and like two shots of my Porter Creek. I think that's good. I think that's perfect because tomorrow that'll be gone. Tonight that'll be gone. I'll go home with no food at all. Looks like I planned that out all right. I gotta get these shoes and socks and pants off. They're all full of danky mud. Yeah, exactly. Gotta wash my feet, wash my socks, wash my shoes, put the shoes and the socks out to dry. Somewhat dry. I don't have good sun access at this site, but whatever. I'm not trying to get all 100%. I just need to dry up a little bit. Let my feet air out, that's the main thing. Look at that. Should I just have my hair like this from now on? Is this like a bring back the 90s kind of thing? I guess that's not that. I'm literally picking sticks up off of the ground, not even sticks, little twigs, like stuff like this.
Well, she looks nice and done. We'll see if the gravel has rehydrated or not.
Well, that worked out pretty good. I let the water boil. I got the water from the lake, let the water boil. And after it had boiled for a couple minutes, I just poured the dehydrated food into that while it was still on the bush buddy. And then that way the bush buddy was out, or going out, and it was still a little residual heat there, and it worked really well, actually. Probably maybe 15 or 20 minutes total. And it's all plumped up. Let's try the gravel. I need a big piece, really test her. Oh, there's a big piece. It's not bad. Not bad. I've had worse. Frank's. It's the last night, so I don't have to be stingy on the Franks. Ooh, it's a lot of Franks. I'm getting racked by mosquitoes right now. You know what I thought I might do? It would only take a couple. I thought I might cut up a little bit of that pepperoni, because I have two left. Maybe it'll only take like that much of it. And cut it up thin and put that in there as a little bonus as I'm eating. I can smell that Frank's. I had to start another fire in that bush buddy. Bugs are getting real bad, the mosquitoes. So this is okay. I might have put a touch too much Franks in there. The little pepperoni pieces are nice. It's almost 8 now. I think I'm gonna go take a little paddle. This water bottle doesn't have a wide mouth on it, so it's not that convenient or quick to fill, but it's no big deal. I always dump out a little bit so that it's definitely less than a liter. That way, the drops are gonna work for sure. Today was a perfect canoe tripping day. It had a little bit of everything. I was on the go for 10 hours today, 7:30 to 5:30. Hard work too. After finding that portage, I really put the move on and got where I needed to go really quick. I was surprised, and it was a good test to see how far, how quick I can go. Tomorrow I'm going to see how quick I can get back to the car. I'm going to push it, get up real early, and just bounce. So I got a big drive ahead of me and all that stuff too. So again, tomorrow I'll be able to see. And I'm going real light on the portages tomorrow. Like, I have no food left. And there's only like 1600 meters worth of portages left. So. Good day. I wouldn't change anything. It was an awesome day. This has been a great trip. I love solo canoe tripping. There's nothing that I've done that compares to it. Everything is so flammable out here. So literally a lighter on twigs. The specific gear that stood out to me on this trip was, in good terms, was number one, the canoe. I couldn't do this without that type of canoe. The Bush Buddy, again, killer. The axe was well more than I needed. It was, I did everything. I did my shavings with it, my limbing with it, my bucking with it, my felling with it, my splitting with it. Great axe. And my shoes, my Morel shoes, dry out real quick. The soles dry out real quick. Super lightweight, ventilated. Yep, those things made this a lot easier. Made it more enjoyable. And I will use these things again on future trips. I think I'm gonna hit the hay soon. Probably do a little checkup with you guys. Check up with you guys as I'm in the tent, as per usual. I'm down to 2 bars left on my last battery out of 4 batteries, but one is garbage, the one I got from Kyle. I'm not complaining though. Cool. If I'm being honest, I'm excited and bummed out both to be going home tomorrow. Excited because go home, see the family, edit this video, be able to watch it all back. Bummed out because I'm just getting into my groove and I feel like I could do another 3 or 4 days and be happy with that. But there's always next time. I think the fall will be a good time for something like that. So, this is a good campsite. My favorite campsite of the trip was last night on Grassy Bay, unexpectedly. But this was good nonetheless. I'm going to hit the hay. It's about 9:30, not even 10 o'clock yet. And I'm tired, so I'm going to get up. If I get up at 5, I'm going to get up at 5. Get up and packed out and all that stuff real early in the morning. I am being serenaded by sounds of the forest. This is my 23rd night out this year. Good night, guys. I'll see you in the morning. Good morning. There is a beautiful sunrise. Reds and purples and pinks all in the sky. It is 5:20. I got up at 5, ate some bars, and got on the water. I'm almost at the highway now. I've been driving down this dirt road for about 20 kilometers. I've seen 9 snapping turtles, a red-eared slider, and a turkey all along this dirt road. That's pretty cool. So the realization that I'm done now is finally kicking in. I really enjoyed my time alone in Algonquin. I'll definitely be back. I saw 12 moose total, a bunch of birds, a rabbit, which is really strange. A bunch of animals. Mid-June is the time to come to Algonquin if you're trying to see animals. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I sure did. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you soon on another adventure. Goodbye.